können?
Ja.
Gunplant.
We think the lakes are going to be pretty easy to win.
Yep.
But we're worried about the portages. A lot of people said this is the most snow they've ever seen up here.
Wow. We're going to try to make it 7 miles in. Question is, will we be able to make it before nightfall?
Two. Got her?
Yep. There's my sled this year. Pretty much the exact same setup as last year. And then here's Brandon's sled. Ski Palk Expedition sled. It's almost a 7-foot sled, fiberglass, riveted top cover with a center zip, and then a cover. Should be nice.
Yeah.
Just Brandon and I this year, 4 nights. So we're doing a nice long one. Be a good opportunity to go a little deeper in than normal and a good opportunity to catch a lot of fish.
We might do a little bit of fishing.
Yeah. Divvying out the minnows. Scored the last of the rainbows at Holiday. Got my water bottle.
What time is it?
12:15.
Okay.
All right. Hunkered down behind this little island here. Throw on the big poofy jacket so we don't get cold. Ingest some energy now and then keep on moving. We're about an hour in, so we'll gauge how far we've made it on the map to get an idea if we're even gonna make it all the way there tonight or if we need to pit stop it.
Whoa!
Finally entering the boundary waters. There's the sign like right there. No more motorized vehicles. All manpower from here on out. Well, we found the portage just right off this creek there, the open water. Well, we were worried that this was going to be very deep and very difficult. However, we're aware of one other group that's been back to this lake recently, and so this trail is very nicely hard packed for us, so it's not too bad at all. Time will tell if we're going to actually make it to our destination tonight. There's a chance we're only going to make it part way today. So, let's see. I don't believe it. That was a short little portage. That was awesome. Quite a journey ahead of us still. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Just a little channel. Got some open water. Crossing from shadow back into sunlight. We were in the shadow of that big cliff for a long time. Woohoo! Oh, it feels good to be out here. Wow. Trail for 5 hours, and now we're faced with the decision of, do we continue on and hike through the night and get to our lake number 4 destination, or do we just set up a spot right here, hunker down for the night, have some food, and leave super early? We'll see. Well, we decided to push on, try to make it to lake number 4. On we go. It's very likely that we are the first humans to walk this trail this winter. Whew, this is a lot of work. Well, lake number 3. Oh, that was a lot of work. I can't believe we're gonna do it, man. We're gonna make it. See the light at the end of the tunnel here. Thank you. and it's almost going all the way down. That's how deep it is.
It's 6:15. It officially took us 6 hours. We left at 12:15.
Yep.
And we are on our final lake destination.
We made it. It's incredible.
Lake number 4. We can just see the sunset back there, just barely setting.
Yeah.
We can see stars. A little bit of light left.
Maybe no moon tonight.
Yeah, no moon. But wow, it feels good. Can't believe we did it. That last portage was brutal.
You blazed it the whole way, man. That was awesome.
They said it was 42 inches of snow they've gotten up here, so it was deep, powdery snow that had not been blazed all winter for sure. Well, onward.